Yeah, I guess once the season's over, I can kind of reflect back on the game and, you know, enjoy the time that I had here. But right now I'm just focusing on just, you know, winning the next game, focusing on just working on it in Colorado and just trying to, you know, get as best as I can.
Have you been working on snaps all season, or is this something that, in the light of the injury, you've been doing more this past bye week?
No, I've always been playing. At pre-practice, I always work on snaps with the backup quarterbacks. And I've always, like, you know, just in case if anything happened, you know, worst case scenario, I would have to, you know, play center. So, yeah, I've always practiced playing center and practiced my snaps just in case I would have to step in there.
How has Doug been doing in that position?
He does a great job. Like I said, I mean, he's real prepared. You know, being a backup, it wasn't like he was just sitting back there and never expecting Aronis to go down or, you know, anything like that. But he was always prepared and he was always working hard just in case he ever had to step in. Well, we listen to one person make the calls, because if there's a lot of guys talking, things can get miscommunicated. So we leave it up to one person, that's the center. But we help the center make calls. You know, he can't always see the whole line because, you know, he's right in the middle. So whatever we see, relay it back to him, and then he just makes the calls from there.
And it's no matter who the center is, whether it's you or Peronis.
Exactly, yep. It's always just the center, no matter who it is.
I just wanted to ask you a couple quick questions. I know I'm sure you've talked about it a lot. What does having Andre back this week do for you?
It's good to have more people back. I mean, you know, at the offensive line position, we have took a lot of injuries. And to get people back, especially with other people going down, it gives us advantage and it helps us, you know, be firm and to support the O-line.
I think Doug was the one who said that when the defense didn't really realize that Andre was back, taking snaps, taking reps, and so on. Could you sort of take me through that, what it was like when they realized, okay, Andre Wise back on field?
I mean, at the same time, I didn't realize he was in there. I know he said he might have do a couple individual reps, nothing team, but when we went out to start team and I seen him at the right tackle, I was kind of shocked for a little bit. And the other guys were like, well, I mean, what are you doing in here? They kind of like didn't expect him to be back so soon. And so it took him like a player or two to kind of realize, oh, this is Andre, and you know, he's ready to go.
I'm guessing, though, it was a pleasant surprise to see him back.
Yeah, no, definitely. It was a kind of a shock, like, wow, you're really back. Awesome. Let's get going.
Any sort of celebration on that?
Any celebration? No, I mean, we have no time to celebrate. We got to get the plays going. So, I mean, yeah, guys were like smiling and, you know, pretty had a shocked look on their face, but that was about it. And then we just started practice.
I know it's not completely back to what it was in that first and second, you know, week of the season, but
yeah,
having Andre and Jake and minus Aronis, what is that feeling amongst the O-line to almost feel like you're back at full strength as to what full strength was at the beginning of the year?
I mean, it gives us a lot of confidence knowing that, you know, a more experienced guy is coming back and to help out the offensive line. It's going to be great, especially, you know, when guys go down like Aronis, we need people to step up. And to see Andre, you know, even though he went through his injury to kind of like fight through it, I mean, he may not be 100% healed, but, you know, he's willing to play. And I just think that's awesome.
How about for Farrell? I'm doing sort of a video get well card for him.
Okay.
So what would you say to him?
Just, I mean, keep fighting through it. I mean, it's I know injuries are tough. Just know that we're here praying for you and that, you know, we're going to keep thinking about you. You're always going to be in our hearts. Just get well soon. 24. Yeah.
And how long have you been on this campus?
Well, I was back here in 2008 with Coach Bilotti, and then I left for a two-year mission. Came back in 2011, and I've been here since.
So this is sort of a second home for you, isn't it?
Yeah, I've been here quite a while.
All right, I'm not going to make it all emotional for you. I'm talking about it.
Okay.
Thanks.
Quick follow-up to what Molly said. I think it was Dwayne Stanford wearing Farrell's number the rest of the year. Have you been on the team before where someone's picked up that number during the season for a fallen teammate?
Yeah, back in 2008 when Todd Doxey passed away, I know it switched around with the DBs. They were 29. So, I mean, that's kind of awesome to see that, you know, Farrell is still being remembered throughout the team and throughout the season.
Yeah, it's obviously not the same thing.
But
you know, what does that sort of galvanize the team at all? Is it sort of just to see that number on the field?
Yeah, I mean, it makes us stronger. We've got to come together and just, like, support each other. I know a lot of guys were close to Farrell, and they were kind of hurt with the injury, but it's still to kind of just boosts the spirits and to see that, you know, guys still really care about each other and that, you know, everyone's a team and we're almost like family.